we know that Jesus sees behind the masks. That Jesus sees us who we really are. Like we just heard from the gospel, Jesus encounters a man named Zacchaeus. And people didn't like him at all because he was a tax collector. And here's how that worked. If you're a tax collector, the government said, oops, except for somebody, that we want this much tax from each person. But a tax collector then would get this much money from them. That's how they make their living. Well, it sounded like Zacchaeus was a wealthy man, and he said he's a sinner. So he probably got this much money from people. Jesus, though, identifies and says, you know, people can't see the good in you, but I can see the good in you. People get stuck on this outward appearance, because he even says in the gospel that he was a short person. It doesn't say that too often in the gospel. Well, someone's identified by how they look, tall or short or skinny. So Jesus sees beyond everything to see who he really is. And it's as if Jesus is saying, Zacchaeus, I see the real self. And I think you are a good person, a lovable person. Well, I would say Jesus says the same thing to us. No matter how much you try to disguise yourself here, kids, but Jesus sees beyond that. He says, no, I see who you really are. And I say, as Jesus, you're great. You're wonderful. You are lovable. Even if you do some bad things, even if you try to disguise, sometimes we get grumpy and we make a fuss. Jesus says, I can see beyond that. I can still see that you are good. Now, in the gospel, Jesus wants to go to Zacchaeus' home. He wants to eat with him. But think of it. We don't usually eat with people we don't like. So we got a sense, it's a real intimate gesture when you go share a meal with somebody. Well, here at the Eucharist, we share a meal with Jesus. And it's become that intimate gesture where, in a sense, we hear again how much God loves us. No matter what we do or what we said. But then, with Zacchaeus, because he is loved, he says, you know, I want to be different. A lot of people think I'm a crook, that they take money, but he stands up and says, I want to be different. I'm going to give money away. I want to help other people. That's exactly our invitation. Because of the love, we're invited to be better. So why don't you help me, kids? I want you to think of some ways. How could kids be better? How could you be better? Yeah. What are some ways? Raise your hand. What are some ways kids could be better, kids? Do your homework without your parents nagging. I mean, just right away. What else could kids do to be better? You stand up there. Okay, you can help other kids. Give money away when there's a collection. You stand up. Help others. Be nice to somebody. What else do kids do? Okay, so you're getting a lot of candy tonight, probably. You could share with some other kids. Maybe give some to your parents or something. You know, you'd be nice. Not just for you. What else do you do to be nice? Okay, parents. Add wine. What else could you do to be nice? Maybe smile, maybe? Kids do to be better. Yeah. Obey your mom and dad, mind who they say. You guys are on a roll here, okay? Just a couple more. What's that? There you go. So do stuff before your parents tell you to do. This happens at school, or if you have a babysitter, or your grandparents, especially your parents. Because you guys know how to act good, don't you? But sometimes we just don't act good. And we put on this costume of grumpiness or disobeying. Yeah, go ahead, stand up. You could give toys, or you can start thinking about the kids. Like, especially Christmas coming, we're having all these special questions. One more, okay, what do you got? What could you do together? Oh, you're Raphael, all right. What about you, Raphael? Maybe share pizza with other kids. Ninjas like turtles. Ninja turtles like pizza. We are called as people of faith to recognize that God sees beyond the masks, beyond the disguises. God sees you as you really are. And hopefully you're going to become like Zacchaeus that says, I want to be better.
just heard St. Paul in the second reading say,
may God bring to fulfillment in you every good purpose,
every effort of faith, so that Christ may shine forth from you. Because when we take up our costume, we take up our mask, we take up all
the disguises, there we find the presence of Christ. Christ is in you, and we can let that shine. So kids, we're going to send you back to your pews, and why don't we give them all a hand? We invite you all.